Greetings. You've seen the problem, the worthless love of Allah. Now, see the alternative, the reality, the truth, the answer, the solution. Islam is a me too, only more, man-made religion. But me too tags along with, or mimics, something else. It mimics the real, the source, the original. So what is the real, the source, the original? The Jewish and Christian God, Jehovah. We have seen the pathetic human love that the Quran defines for the Allah of its pages. Allah only loves those who love Him first. Allah only loves those who believe in Him. Allah only loves those who purify themselves without His help. This is such a vivid differentiator. It must be examined and highlighted. I claim Jehovah is the real, the source, the original. Let's see how the Bible documents the love of the real God, Jehovah. Do not let your mind run away attempting to extrapolate examples of judgment. But God said, kill, blah, blah, blah. I did not slam Allah because of His acts of hatred and terrorism, but only for His description of Himself, His love, assuming the Quran is by Him and is His words. To be fair and balanced, I will simply apply the same standard to examining God's word revealing Him and His love. John 3:16, for God so loved the world. Drop the mic. The world. Not believers, not His followers, not even the elect. No ifs, ands, or buts about who God loves. He loves the world. This means every human to ever live, righteous and even unrighteous. But this was no empty words, flowery speech kind of love. God's love motivated Him, compelled Him to do something. For God so loved the world that He gave the only begotten Son. Jehovah God's love is so intense, God was willing to do something extraordinary. God gave, sacrificed the most precious thing humans could comprehend, the only begotten Son. But why? Why do such a horrible thing? What's the reason? What's the so that everyone believing in Him should not perish, but should have eternal life? If you decide to believe, you will receive eternal life. It's your choice, your free will, your decision, your call. All you have to do is believe God's promises. But this all comes from God's love, His nature. 1 John 4:7. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. I highlight the three English words love because they all derive from the Greek word agape. Agape is a self-sacrificing love that does not seek for itself. If you show love to someone who can offer no possible benefit or value to you, that is an example of agape. Let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. God is agape. God is a self-sacrificing love that does not seek for itself. This is why God was motivated inspired, compelled to sacrifice himself for the world. For God so loved the world that he gave the only begotten Son, so that everyone believing in him should not perish, but should have eternal life. This love with which God loved the world is agape, the same Greek word for a self-sacrificing love. Muslims are taught the name Al-Wadud, which is described as the source, quote-unquote, of love. But which God is actually a source of love? Allah, who does not and cannot love those who do not love him? Jehovah, who loves the world so much he must act to save it? 1 John 4:9. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. God manifested his love, made visible, made it clear, made it obvious, made plain his love, so that we might live through him. Again, the reason, the purpose. It was for us. God has nothing to gain, nothing we can provide, except perhaps our love, our free choice to love him back. In this is love, not that we have loved God. Remember, the Allah of Islam only loves those who love him first. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Jehovah God of the Bible, the Jewish and Christian scriptures, loved the world and loved us first. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. If God set the example first for us to follow, we should follow his lead. This is the reason Allah's pathetic human love is so damning, so invented by the mind of men. The alternative by Jehovah is brighter than the sun. Romans 5:8. But God proves his love for us in this. Yet another difference between the real God, Jehovah, and the fake man-made deity, Allah. God has proven his love, and by proving his love, proves his own existence. But God proves his love for us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. While we were sinners, before we obeyed, before acting aright, before loving him, while we were treacherous sinners, thieves, murderers, liars, did not rely on him, we were disobedient to parents, Jehovah God loved us first. Which is actually the source of love? The Allah who does not and cannot love those who do not love him? Or Jehovah, who loves the world so much he must act to save it? The answers are clear. Whose love is intense? Jehovah, with agape love so intense, he died for us. Who is the source of love? Jehovah, because he is agape love. His love was given freely to the world before we could love. Again, who is the source of love? Allah cannot be the source, because you must love Allah before he can love you. In fantasy Allah world, you are the source of love. In the Bible, the Jewish and Christian scriptures, Yehovah God is the true source of all love. It just so happens He is love and therefore the eternal source of love. The worthless love of Allah is still reason number 15 to reject Islam. The priceless, self-sacrificing love of Yehovah God may be the number one reason to accept Jesus as Lord and recognize Him as the Son of Man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.